students, welcome to this online video lecture on fluid mechanics. So whatever concepts and numericals discussed in the previous video, hope you have understood all those concepts and numericals. Still, if you are having any doubts, you can comment them in the comment box and we'll try to clarify your doubts. So today in this video, we're going to start with a new concept, and further as the session goes, we'll solve some of the numericals on to related to that concepts. So without wasting much time, let us begin with this session. So in the previous video, we have discussed orifice meter as well as some of the numericals on the orifice meter. So today in this video, we'll going to derive the equation for velocity, to determine velocity to identify the velocity by using a Pitot tube. So what is this Pitot tube? So Pitot tube is a device used to measure the velocity of a flow at any point in a pipe or a channel. So whatever this figure you are observing, this is a schematic diagram of Pitot tube. And this Pitot tube is consists of a glass tube which is bent at a right angle. So this blue color line what you are observing, so this is a Pitot tube. Now this principle of Pitot tube was developed by Henry de Pitot. So this was developed by Henry de Pitot, and it works on the principle that if the velocity at any point becomes zero, the pressure head at that point increased due to the conversion of kinetic energy into the pressure energy. Okay, in any flow, during the flow of fluid, at any point, if the velocity of a flow becomes zero, at that particular point, there will be the conversion of kinetic energy into the pressure energy. As a result, the pressure at that particular point will increases. Now let us derive the velocity equation by using a Pitot tube now. Okay, let us consider section 1 and 2. Okay, section 2 at the entry of Pitot and section 1 at any particular point in the flow. Let P1, V1 be the pressure and velocity at section 1. Okay, this is a section 1. Similarly, P2, V2 be the pressure and velocity at section 2. Okay, section 2. Now by applying the Bernoulli's principle, so we have P1 divided by rho g plus V1 square divided by 2g plus Z1 will be equals to P1 divided by rho g plus V2 square divided by 2g plus Z2. So this is a Bernoulli's principle. By applying the Bernoulli's principle at section 1 and section 2, we have this. Now by observing the figure, you can say that both Z1 and Z2, because as the, both the points are in the same line, so I can say Z1 will be equals to Z2. And one more assumption will be that is V2 will become 0. From the principle of this Pitot tube, that it says at any point if the velocity becomes 0. Now at this point, the velocity will be 0. So if I substitute this one, I will get the equation P1 divided by rho g plus V1 square divided by 2g will be equals to P2 by rho g. This is our left out equation. And we know that, that is P1 divided by rho g is a pressure head at section 1. Okay, so that is equals to H1. Okay, now similarly, P2 divided by rho g is a pressure head at section 2. Now this head will be equals to H plus H1. So that is H1 plus H. This is a pressure head at section 2. Now let us substitute this H plus H1 and H in this equation. So that will be H1 plus V1 square divided by 2G will be equals to H1 plus H. So this H1 and this H1 will get cancelled. The left out equation will be H is equals to V1 square divided by 2G. Now from this equation, I can get velocity at point 1. Okay, that is a V1 will be equals to, if I rearrange this one, so I will get V1 will be equals to root of 2gh root of 2h. So square is there, so if I have taken this square root, so this is our velocity at section 2. Now this is a theoretical velocity, okay? So this V1 is equals to root of 2hg is a theoretical velocity at section 1. Now actual velocity is given by Cv into root of 2gh, where Cv is a coefficient of p dot tube, where Cv is a coefficient of p dot tube. Okay, now this is our final actual velocity at any particular point through a p dot tube, that is V actual is equals to Cv into 2gh. Okay, so if you derive this much, so it will be for complete 8 marks, you will get it. And even based on this p dot tube, we will be having a numericals. So let us solve some of the numericals which have appeared in the university examination on a p dot tube. And this question is asked for 10 marks. Okay, and the question is, a p dot tube is used to measure the velocity of an air flow in a duct. A U2 manometer shows 12 mm of water. If the coefficient of p dot tube is 0.98, find the velocity and mass of an airflow. Assume the specific weight of an air as 10 newton per meter cube and duct diameter as 500 mm. So this is a simple numerical and it is asked for 8 marks. It is asked for 8 marks in the university examination. So let us solve this one. Before that, let us note down the given data in this problem. So first thing is, the manometer shows, that is, I'll consider x deflection, that is 12 mm. So in meters it will be 0.012 meter. The next, the specific weight of air is given. Okay, so that is specific weight, that is 10 newton meter cube. Then coefficient of p dot tube is given, that is 0.98. then diameter is given, that is 500 mm. So if I convert that, so that will be 0.5 meter. Okay, now we have got deflection, diameter of duct, specific weight of an air, then coefficient of p dot tube. Okay, let us calculate this area 1, that is diameter of duct, area of duct, that is pi by 4 into d1 square. So it is pi by 4 into 0.5 square, so it will be 0.1963 meter square. Now we know that velocity is equals to Cv into root 2gh, where g is a gravitational constant, that is 9.81, but h is to be identified. Now h will be equals to, it is as we have calculated in previous step, head, that is deflection in manometer divided by the manometer which fluid it consists, it is consisting of water. Okay, so it is density, that is 9000, it consists of water, 1000 into 9.81 divided by specific weight of an air, so that is 10 minus 1. So here is a deflection. What is that deflection? That is 0.012. okay, now if you do this, you should simplify this, you will get h will be equals to, so you will get it around 11.75 meter of air. this is a head now. So let us substitute this h in this equation. Now that is v is equals to cv is 0.98 into root of 2 into 9.81 into 11.75. So the velocity at section equals to, that is 14.88 meter per second. So this much velocity will get it in the pitot tube. Okay, now this is a one step we have calculated. The next one more thing is to be identified is mass flow rate of it, of an air. Now we know that q is equals to a1 v1. Q is equals to a1 v1. So we have calculated the a1. So let us do that. 0.1963 into v1 is 14.81. So that q will be equals to 2.922 meter cube per second. This is a discharge now. So this is not our answer. So the mass flow rate of air is equals to, so density of air is given. So mass flow rate is equals to discharge into discharge, that is Q, into density of air divided by gravitational constant. So that will be equals to 2.922 into the density is given, that is 10 divided by 9.81. So your mass flow rate will be equals to, so the mass flow rate will be equals to, will be equals to, you'll get it around 2.98 kg per second. So this is our answer. Okay, the mass flow rate is given by Q into density of that fluid divided by gravitational constant. So if you solve this much, you'll get complete 8 marks.